Good evening. Thank you for joining me. I'm D. Lake from Prez, David Lake, reporting for TheMediaSpeaks.com. Tonight, we're going to talk politics. That's right, the presidential race. It's really heating up. All right, we had that first debate last week. I watched the debate. And I'd say my opinion, well, first of all, my opinion was it sucked. Because it was just the two heavyweights. You know, the Republican and Democratic parties. And look what I got here, okay? The Romney and Obama empty cups. All right, Clint Eastwood. All right, he's a big-time actor, great director. You know, I'm just D-Lake for Prez, okay? I'm not Clint Eastwood. He made a big deal out of empty chair, and the media ran with it. Whoa, did they run with it. Graphic artists start doing funny things, memes come out. And the whole entire internet gets carried away with empty chair. Check it out, ladies and gentlemen. All right, empty cups. Romney, Obama, nothing in them, okay? And I've already said it before, this is the Bush Cup. HW, he fully, and the whole family, they fully support and endorse Bain Capital, former CEO, whatever, big head honcho over there, Romney. Willard Mittens Romney. Mittens Protection Program. And the Clintons, the Bushes and the Clintons. Okay, those two families that have been running the country and expanding the size of government for well over 20 years, okay? And now guess who's getting mixed up in it? Big Bird. Yeah, Big Bird. Big Bird, it seems, is thrilled about his cameo in the presidential race. Why would he be? I mean, Snuffleupagus is pissed. You know, I love Big Bird, the Republican challenger said, but I'm not going to keep on spending money on things to borrow money from China to pay for it. Well, I mean, maybe that's a good point, but you said Big Bird, okay? And now we're running with it. The Obama campaign's running with it. PBS doesn't like it. The ad shows images of Bernie Madoff and others implicated in various financial and corporate scandals. The narrator then intones, and the evil genius who towers over them? Question mark. A silhouette of Big Bird flashes on screen. Mitt Romney knows it's not Wall Street you have to worry about. It's Sesame Street. The narrator said. So, Obama had a rough night at that debate. The Pew poll is devastating. Just devastating. Before the debate, Obama had a 51-43 lead. Now, Romney has a 49-45 lead. That's a simply unprecedented reversal for a candidate in October. Before, Obama had leads on every policy issue and personal characteristic. Now, Romney leads in almost all of them. Obama's performance gave Romney a 12-point swing. I repeat, a 12-point swing. Anyways, it is October 9th, 2012. Tomorrow, 10th. There's another debate. Only this time, it's Biden versus Ryan. Alright? Vice President Joe Biden has not sat down for nationally televised interview in 5 months. The last big TV interview Biden did was on NBC's Meet the Press, when he jumped the gun and came out in favor of gay marriage, before President Obama was able to publicly shift his position. Days later, Obama did his own nationally televised interview and expressed his own support for that initiative. I support the initiative. Biden's Meet the Press interview aired Sunday, May 6th, 2012. Again, it's October 9th, 2012. Okay, so it's been like 5 months in between televised interviews. Well, maybe he's been doing some other kind of interviews. No, you're wrong. Joe Biden gets used by the Obama campaign like Bernie from Weekend at Bernie's, says the Republican source. Alright, so okay. They drag him out to a battleground state, prop him up on a podium in front of a teleprompter, pose him for photos with locals, and then quickly roll chance to ask him questions. They want Biden to be seen but not heard in any interviews because they're afraid he might embarrass the president with another one of his hilarious gaffes. And I guess it depends on who you are or the tone in this guy's voice when he uses the word hilarious. Because they are hilarious in one way, but it's sad and disappointing and kind of pisses me off in another way. Okay? When these are the kind of guys that we're dealing with, and maybe you've seen some of my previous reports where I talk about how much Obama loves golf, and I don't know how many rounds he's gotten lately, but it might explain the way he looked the other night. You know? Maybe that's a golf thing and we wouldn't understand. We haven't played over 100 rounds in the past 3 years. Alright? I don't know how many other people, golfers. I'm going to go to a golf course and talk to some golfers. See what their, how many rounds they get in an average year. Or I could go on the fancy Google machine and figure it out right here. Alright? But it'd be more fun if we talked to the golfers, right? Alright, so look forward to that. I'm D-Lake for Prez, David Lake, reporting for themediaspeaks.com. Have a good night.